sit for thy penitence, O Lord.
For all false judgments, for our charitable thoughts towards our enemies, and for our prejudice and contempt towards those who differ from us.
Accept our penitence, O Lord.
For our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who come after us.
Accept our penitence, O Lord.
Restore us to the Lord, and let your anger depart from us.
Wonderful. We pray together. Father, we offer you these gifts that you have given us, this bread, this wine, this money. We thank you.
That they may be unto us the body and blood of your Son,
our Savior Jesus Christ. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this and eat it. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Now for supper, he took the cup of wine. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." In faith, we acclaim you, O Christ. The blessed passion, mighty resurrection, and glorious ascension of your beloved Son, do offer unto your divine majesty this bread of eternal life and this cup of everlasting salvation, rendering thanks to you for the wonderful redemption which you have made possible for us in Christ. And we beseech you, O Father, to accept upon your heavenly altar this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, and to grant that by the merits and death of your Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all your holy church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And we pray that by the power of your Holy Spirit, all who shall be partakers of this holy communion will be filled with your grace and heavenly benediction, and be numbered in the glorious company of your saints. And here we offer and present unto you, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and lively sacrifice. And although we are unworthy to offer unto you any sacrifice, yet we beseech you to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom, and with whom, and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be unto you, O Father Almighty, throughout all ages, now and forever.
Mercy on
be one of the 48th second of the course of your prayers. Pray together. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you, and all persons in you, with gladness and singleness of heart, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Christ, give you grace to grow in holiness, to deny yourselves, take up your cross, and follow me. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Now have the blessing of the children.
Anyone else in need of special prayer, we'll put forward our list.
Jerusalem.
The city that kills the prophets and stones those who are sent to it. How often have I desired to gather your children together, as a hen gathers her brood under her wings, and you are not willing. See, your house is left to you. And I tell you, you will not see me until the time comes when you say, blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord.
Friends, members who have been away, we are indeed happy have you worshiping with us this morning. We thank our young people, our young ones, for doing the readings this morning. Thanks to Mr. Emerson Sutherland for assisting us that we could get our second projector and screen up and running. Rose and Papa.